This is not a technical Nostr deep dive. It does go a little bit into technical, but this is not. This is super new. There are folks here that are able to do the technical side, but some aren't. So I wanted to just present this, like introduce all of this. So what is Nostr? Nostr stands for Notes and Other Stuff Transmitted by Relays. I'm not even kidding. Like, that is literally how Jeff came up with the name. It's N-O-S-T-R. Like, that's what it was. And he didn't know what to call it, so he named it that. It wasn't even a Twitter play. It, you know, Twitter, Nostr, it had nothing to do with that. What Nostr is trying to be, it's a open protocol for communication. And it's very specific that everyone that works on Nostr it's actually interesting because everyone is like, it may work. No one knows if it's going to work and it may fail miserably, but it may work, right? It has the chance to work, unlike a bunch of other implementations and a bunch of other things. And the way to think of it is a decentralized Twitter or Facebook or a decentralized social media, right? A layer that is unique for all of these. Why are we all talking about this thing? To be very honest, like none of you would know about Nostr. None of us would know. I would know, but no one of you would know about Nostr because if it wasn't for this guy, Jack Dorsey put out a blog post on December something and saying, you know, supporting open protocols in the internet. Like, how do I do this? And he had some stuff to talk about. And in that post, everyone started commenting Nostr, Nostr, Nostr. I don't know about everyone, but he saw that and then said, maybe I should check it out. Discovered it, read the readme, and then discovered that Fiajap is the creator and said, great, let's give this guy $250,000 because why not? I'm a billionaire. So that's what he did. He literally reached out on DMs and said, hey, I want to support funding. I'd like to do that. And, you know, great. So Fiajap works at ZEBEDEE. She has been working at ZEBEDEE for the past 2.5 years. And so he messaged me immediately when Jack Dorsey texted him and he said, is this fake? And I said, I don't know, but what is this? It looks fake. I said, yeah, he wants to give us money. I was like, for what? I don't know. It's for ZEBEDEE. This is exciting. And he's like, no, he wants to fund Nostr. And I said, okay, maybe just give him an address and maybe he'll give you some Bitcoin. And then he sent me, you know, 10 minutes later, he sent me this many sats, but he sent it in sats. And so I was like, oh, he sent you 1.4 Bitcoin, you know, okay, cool. Like 25K. And then he said, no, 14 Bitcoin. And I said, oh shit, that's $250,000. You know, like that's not a little money. And then everything exploded, right? And literally it was December 15th, right? Literally it was December 15th. It had been growing organically for the past 2 years. And then it was increasing velocity, right? You see that it's starting to slope and then it just skyrocketed, right? This is just one metric, one way to think of it as like active development. This is GitHub stars, right? So developers, they're like, oh, this is interesting, right? And it's a used metric around developers. Yeah. And then what I find interesting is like, this is now old. There are over 500,000 pub keys, which means, you know, users or identities in the network now. And there's over 2 million events and so on. But I think it's important to compare it, right? Like, what does this actually mean? Let's compare it. So on the right is Bitcoin and their chart, right? And on the top is IPFS, which is another decentralized data storage solution. On the bottom, it's LND, which is relating to, you know, everyone knows LND. And so this spike is very significant, right? It's not like a little thing that it happens to every protocol and happens to everything. It's very significant and it has yet to slope the plateau. It just keeps going up, right? So let's continue watching it. It's exciting. It's growing really fast. And this is something that people don't really talk about. And I'm really proud of. But Fiajap has been working at ZEBEDEE for the past 2.5 years. I remember him showing Nostr for us for the first time. And I was like, huh, fun. Maybe that'll work, you know? And people started helping here and building this and building that. And then last year we announced the NBD project, which stands for No Big Deal. And that is our open, it's seriously, that's what it stands for. And our open source arm is called No Big Deal. And Fiajap is the main sort of lead person of that. And so I tweeted this the other day, I don't have it here, but No Big Deal created Notes and Other Stuff Transmitted by Relays, right? Like that's what, like NBD created Nostr. But it's pretty cool. And we've seen the growth of that from day zero, right? We were involved since all of these. So why Nostr? What the hell does it solve? Why are we even talking about it? Nowadays, you have Twitter and you have Facebook and you have TikTok and you have Instagram and you have all of them, right? Like all the myriad of them. And what do they all have? They all have their own infrastructure. They all have their own user. They all have their own data storage. They all have their own web apps and mobile apps and desktop apps and all of the things, Telegram, right? And the thing here is you can't pop from TikTok to Telegram or Instagram to Facebook. And I guess Instagram and Facebook might be able to, but you simply can't. Like, they don't interoperate. Like, these are closed source companies, right? And so your users, your friends have to go to Twitter for you to buff them on Twitter. And this sucks. This sucks. This is similar to what Bitcoin is trying to solve with money, right? Your dollars in Chase, can't be sent to a bank in the EU because there are different monies. But it's all the same, you know? It's why don't we all interoperate on the money layer so we can, you know, communicate? So let's just go back a little bit, like emails. And, you know, this is my hand drawing. It's great. It's spot on. It's really good. But it gets the point across, right? Emails. Why does email work so well and why is it so widespread? It's because it's a standard, it's a protocol. You can have Outlook, go to Google, go to Gmail, go to ProtonMail, go to live.com. You can have your own hosted, you can host your own email and it could be andre.com and you could send emails that way. And it's because it's the simple mail transfer protocol, right? Like, people just use the same sentence, the same language, and you can pop each other. Why the hell don't we do that? Right? Why don't we do that with social media? Why don't we have a layer of social communication, identity, whatever it is, and call that Nostr, for lack of a better name? And instead of having individual users on Facebook, individual users on Twitter and TikTok, let's all be like, those could be client, those can interact with the protocol. And so you could send a message from Twitter to your friend that's using Facebook because it's using, like, the users are all the same, right? It's all the same. And I'm going to go into detail on this. This is what we would want, right? This is what we were on. You carry one identity and you can use Twitter or Facebook or Google or your own provider or your own web app. And they all interoperate with the same ease of use. So how do we do this? Like, what is Nostr? How does it do that? Nostr is Schnorr signed JSON messages relayed over WebSocket first. It's like, whoa, mouthful. I don't know what that means. Let's break it down. Schnorr signed, who's heard of Schnorr? Right? Everyone's heard of Schnorr, right? Okay, great. Schnorr. So Schnorr is a digital signature scheme, and it's just a cryptographic signing. It's a way to cryptographically sign something. So if you create a message, you know, and then you sign it, you can say, okay, this is my signature. You can prove that you signed it. You can do that cryptographically. You can use this. Like, this is one way to sign something cryptographically. So you can prove it through math that this was you indeed that signed this. So this is important because on Twitter, when you make a post, it's Twitter saying you made that post, right? Because on a decentralized network, no one is saying that Andre made a post. I have to prove that I'm the only one that made that post. So I have to cryptographically prove that. So it's Schnorr signed. JSON is just a format. It's a data format. It like looks like this. It's just, you know, name, its properties, the key value pairs. It's just a way to present data. And then WebSockets, I don't know why it's so bad, the image. But WebSockets, if you've ever used like an app, what's happening behind the scenes is you're making calls to a server, right? So it like goes to the server and says, post this. And then it comes back, say, okay, it's posted. This is an API interface and it goes and comes back and it closes, right? A WebSocket interface, it goes and it stays open. So you maintain an open connection to a server and so you can quickly send messages back and forth, right? It's no different than what we do nowadays, but instead of opening a connection, closing a connection, opening a connection, closing a connection for each little thing, I just open it once and then events or posts or messages can just stream from my app, right? If you've ever seen an app that updates real time, that's what this is. It's WebSockets, right? Usually. What we have, God, so bad. Now that I see it again, it's really bad drawing, right? So what we have now is, this is what the Nostr network is like, right? You have hundreds of relays. There's two parties in Nostr. There is relays and there's clients, okay? A relay is a server that just sits up there and you can push messages to it and you can also fetch messages from it, right? And there are hundreds of relays out there. And so you can push message to one relay or you can push messages to all relays or a few relays, right? And whenever you want to follow someone, for example, so let's say I want to follow Brianna and I want to say, okay, great. I want to see her posts, right? So when I open my app is going to go to these relays and say, hey, show me the posts from this user, right? and then it's going to fetch and show it to me. So when you have a follow list, or you have a list of followers or people follow you and you make a post, what's happening is a client is going out, your app is going out to these relays. It's saying, hey, give me the information from this user, and then it's pushing to your app, right? And so you've seen that. With Twitter, this happens because you're going to Twitter and Twitter is saying, here's your posts. And then with Nostr, you're going to multiple relays, right? And you're saying that. And then because of that, because there's no central server, it has a chance of working in a decentralized way, because there is no central source of truth or central source of like, if this goes down, the entire network goes down. If one relay goes down, you can connect to another relay. If you get kicked out of a relay, someone said, the relay owner says, I don't like your messages, you could then start pushing messages to another relay, right? So this is how it works on the relay side. You have multiple relays and they just provide information. They do storage and they do compute. And then what you have is client. Clients are the apps. So let's think of it like that. So when you go on the phone and you go to Twitter, that's an app. And then it's connecting to the Twitter server, right? One way to think of it is Twitter could be a client, and Twitter could also be a relay, but it doesn't have to be the only relay, right? That's, I'm trying to equate it there. And so how do you think about data in Nostr? How does this work, right? Everything in Nostr is an event. Literally, that's it. It's very simple protocol. It's an event. So if you make a post and you want to, I'm using Twitter as the example, right? So you want to make a post, it's literally this, good morning, right? And you make a post and you push it to relays, and that's it. It has other properties. The specific one that you want to look at is public key and signature, right? The pub key is your pub key, you, and I'm going to talk about pub key. And signature is what I just talked about. It's you proving that this is mine. Like, I just signed it cryptographically, can't be messed up with. So here you go. I'm signing this with my digital signature. And so everything in Nostr is this event. So if you are updating your profile picture, it's an event. If you're updating, if you're up following someone, it's an event. If you post a message, it's an event. Like, all an event. Remember this thing here, right? Where you have Facebook, Twitter, and TikTok. This is a future we'd love to have. What we currently have is things like this, right? This is the exact same drawing, but instead of Facebook, Twitter, and TikTok, you have Iris and Damas and Snorts and this myriad number of clients, right? Because anyone can write a client. So for example, imagine you could write your own Twitter client and interact with Twitter, and then it has its own capabilities, its own features, its own things, right? So anyone can use any client. So the same way that I can use Gmail, or I can use Outlook, and I can use Live.com, and I can use all this stuff, I can do that. Why can't my user on Twitter work on Google or on Facebook? It's because the database, like Facebook doesn't have access to the Twitter database to validate whether my username and password is correct, right? They don't have access, they don't talk to each other. In cryptographic schemes, you have public and private keys. This is how you sort of prove who you are. So let's just go back. Emails and passwords, right? Like how does that work? Email is public and password is private. So one is to identify you in a public sense. The other one is to prove that you are you, right? In private key, in cryptographic key signing schemes, you have public keys and private keys. So public key is your identifier. It's here's my public key. I 12567, whatever the public key is, it's a hash. And then a private key is your password, like thing. Don't expose your private key. We're all familiar with Bitcoin, private keys, right? Same thing. So the same infrastructure works across clients because the same private key and public key worked across clients, right? So let's do a demo because no one wants to listen to this dumb stuff. Cool. So I'm going to go to a client and I'm going to create a new user. And I'm not kidding, this is a client. I'm going to log out. So I'm going to create an account and I'm going to generate key. So great. I don't want to follow anyone, but whatever. Sure. Continue. Great. I already follow some people. Cool. So I just created my user, right? This is it. But then behind the scenes, it created for me a private key and a public key. Okay. That's what just happened. This here is my public key and pub. So Nostr, pub, whatever. That's my public key. So if you want to find this user in any of the Nostr interfaces, you just use this key and you can like find me, right? This is fine because it's a user that we're using for testing. But this is my private key, right? Usually, you would want to create your private key and your public key somewhere safe, not on a random website that someone can see, right? So, but we're gonna, keep it here, right? So, one thing that I wanted to do is say, okay, let's go and make a post, right? So let's say, hello world. So I just made a post. This is my post, right? And this is in Snorts. And this is what this is. And I can change my profile. I'm not going to do everything, but I could change my profile picture. I could change my name. I could add descriptions. I could do all those things, right? But just to keep it simple, remember, everything is an event, right? So I'm just doing an event. We could do another event. And great. So now if I go to my profile, I have two events, right? So now I would love to use another one. This one looks a lot like Twitter. Wow. Holy crap. This is super good, isn't it? Hamster.to. Who the hell built that? No idea. Right. So I'm going to go here to Nostr to get my private key, right? Because I want to log in to the other client. So again, you don't want to do this, but I'm going to show everyone my private key, you know, and secure it as my private key secret. And I'm going to go to this other one, and I'm going to log in with my key. Let me log in with T. And again, there you go. Logging in. Boom. Right. So I just logged into another client, and I go over here. Wow, my events are there. Holy crap. Right? My posts are here. And I can go to any Nostr client. And it could be web app. It could be mobile app. It could be desktop app. You can carry your identity across, right? So, and similarly, I can make posts from here. So let's post from Hamster. And now it's here, and it was published to 3Relay. See? So now there are 3Relays out there that are doing that. And so if anyone were to follow my pub key, they would see that. If I go back to Snort and I look at my posts, oh, it's not here. Okay, why is that? Maybe I'm not connected to the same relays. Let's see. I'm not connected to the same relays. Let's go back to Snort, or to Hamster. Let's check what relays I'm connected to. I'm connected to these 3 relays, right? So it'd be great if we had shared relays. But let's see what relays I'm connected to here. And I say, okay, relays I'm connected to Avanchmore. Wow, okay, cool, interesting. I don't know why it's not propagating. So I'm going to touch on relays in a second. I'll show you our relay. I don't know why it's not loading the last one. Relays have to check the signature against the public key of every event. Now, anyone could create another public key, a private key pair, and then put a photo of Elon and do all this stuff, right? And like description and so on, and then post somewhere and say, this is Elon. But it'd be a different public key, right? So then it becomes a discoverability issue. How do you know Elon's public key, right? Then it's like, okay. And that's what Twitter solves these days is, how do I find someone's email? I go to their Twitter profile, right? So there's big questions here. It's not going to be, okay, nowadays it's Nostr and then there used to be Twitter, right? It's much more involved. Is ZEBEDEE building a client? I think we are at a position where like we know the technology really well and we want to do something with it. We have plans, but I don't know that we're ready to be at that stage. The big question is like, okay, now that we have this open communication network, how do you monetize this? What's the business model of any of this, right? Because this is the beginning of Lightning was the same thing. You know, you altruistically run a Lightning node because you want to help the network, not because you're making money off of it. but I think it's something that nowadays enthusiasts are doing because they want the growth of the network. I think, so I have a piece coming out in like next week about monetization of relays and paid relays. And I'm going to touch on that because imagine running a relay and hosting hundreds of thousands of users and public keys in their events, right? One user could make 1,000, 10 million, you know, the posts, events, Twitter, like it's huge, right? So it gets expensive to run this stuff. And at scale, we're not talking about 500,000 users. Twitter has 250 million daily active users. So I'm not saying you have to get to that level, but even 1 million daily active users, this relay is gigantic, right? So it has to be monetizable. And so what we're seeing now is actually that relays are introducing monetizable capabilities. And so this is actually something that we just rolled out yesterday. So here's a relay called Milu. And in order to push events to it or fetch events to it, you have to pay such that your public key is added to a list that says, okay, your public key is good. You know, you can post to my relay, right? And so if I add my public key here, which I can, you know, I could show that and do it. You can pay for it. So if I get my public key here, I'll add it here. You know, I have you can have a terms of service, so you're not going to engage in spam and et cetera, et cetera. And if you do spam, I'm just going to kick you out, right? And, you know, close it, great. I've read it, pay 1,000 sats. It brings up a Lightning invoice. You pay that invoice, or Brianna pays the invoice. Imagine your Twitter and you run a relay, right? But you don't make any money running your relay. But your relay is really expensive. It costs you $1 million a month to run that relay because it has so many users, so much data, and it costs a lot more actually. How do you make that money back? Okay, you could put a subscription on the app and say everyone that wants to use the Twitter relay has to pay $8. Or I could say, okay, in order to post events to my relay, to the Twitter relay, every post you make, you have to pay 50 cents, right? That's one way to monetize it, but that's very friction rich. You know, how does that work? That's not gonna work. So what if you pay an admission fee and say, okay, in order to post here, I'm just saying it costs $10. And from now on, you can post to the Twitter relay. And if you start posting unwanted things, you know, racist things, sexual things, et cetera, I'm gonna kick you off, right? And I'll just cut you off. You can still go to another relay. That's the other thing, right? Public relays right now are bombarded. So what happens is a client opens, that you open your app, your client, and it goes to the relays that you set. And it's like, here's all the information I want. So imagine you have 1,000, you follow 1,000 accounts. You're literally going to that server and saying, give me all the content for these 1,000 accounts. That's heavy. And imagine you have 100,000 users accessing that relay. That's heavy. Your relay is going to start flowing down unless you pay for more and it's more expensive, but it gets heavy. So the big relays, Dama's relays, the ZEBEDEE Cloud relay, the Snort relay, they are not as fast as other relays. Now, what happens is what we're doing with the Milu relay, for example, when you pay for this and you get in, right now it's like, okay, no one's using this, so what's the point, right? No, we are fetching the events directly from the other relays and shoving into Milu. So your response time is much quicker because there aren't 100,000 people accessing the Milu relay. There's 50, there's 100, there's 1,000. So your response time is lower. Your data bit, you're like, maybe we'll give you the ability to upload photos, right? So you're paying for a slightly premium service. And it goes back to the whole thing. It's premium until you want added features. And so you want response time, you want stability. You want something. If you use Nostr a little bit these days, it crashes. It doesn't crash, but the clients sometimes can't handle the data. Like they can't load stuff. They're not ready. And it's really early, right? So I think it'll go in stages, right? I think we will monetize the access to the relay because spam is going to be everywhere if it just grows, bots and everything. And so it will be paid. And then they will find ways to introduce whether it's like little proof of work things and et cetera to remove the actual cost, like the social cost, but still be costly against bots and spams. And then they'll monetize in different ways, like you said. So here's an example, right? Like if you're trying to find someone, it's like, how the hell am I going to give someone this address, this hash string, right? So I'm going to say, okay, hey, you're in your client. You don't use my client, right? You're just like, oh, I'm in my app. I want to find you, Andre. I'm going to type Andre at, and in this case, ZBD.AI. And that's my alias, right? And then it points to my public key so that you can find me, right? And then you could have, you know, BHD at ZBD.AI, and you can map these. So what he's saying is there's countless services now that provide you the ability to pair your public key to an email address looking thing. So you could say, find me at andre@andre.com, right? Yes, because the same person, my take is the same person that has been pushed, the same people that have been pushing this or building on it are also in the Bitcoin Lightning community specifically, right? Kijap is really big in Lightning. He's been doing all this stuff. And then when he put it out, the first people to get involved with it are the people that are involved with him. And those are like Lightning developers, Bitcoin developers, and so on. And then I guess that the thesis, the ethos of the decentralization is very, you know, compatible. And so it leads to it. I hope that Bitcoin helps Nostr, but I don't want it to be a Bitcoin thing because it will not grow. Then it becomes like a cringing thing that no one outside of Bitcoin wants to touch. And that's not the point. So it has to help, but it can't be it. So yeah, I think that's it. I have two slides real quick. Yeah, it's very early, very, very early. It'll break, okay? Fuck around with it, mess with it, but it'll break. It's very early. And then there's so much more to this, right? I have not touched on everything. And I think it's you know, scratching the surface. Get involved. There's a Telegram channel. Make a Nostr client and start talking to people, or just create a public key and go just Google Nostr. You'll find stuff. It's like, it's now big enough. And again, we talked about BTC and Nostr is really interesting. It's open money and it's open communication. So like get involved. And our way of getting involved is, one, ZEBEDEE is not only do we fund via Jeff and et cetera, and we have plans to interact with it, but we're also doing stuff on the side, right? We're all developers and hackers. And so Brianna and I have been building this Bitcoin Nostr toolkit for the past couple months, weeks actually. And it's called Milu, because it's Milu, and it's going to be live soon. It's a one-stop shop for like your Bitcoin and Nostr user needs. It's not a key storage. It's not cryptographic stuff. It's how do I use it? What clients do I go to? What are the resources? What are the latest podcasts do I learn from? How do I convert my Satoshi to BTC? How do I find this user in Nostr? I have their public key. I don't know where to go. And then the latest stuff, right? So this happened, it's going to pop up in this app. Or this got released, it's going to pop up in this app. And so for anyone that wants to interact with Nostr and wants to learn and wants to get involved and wants to be up to date, you just download Milu and you'll have everything, right? That's kind of our little way of contributing, right? Because it's a decentralized network. And so there is no central place of curation or like a discovery. We can't go to somewhere and find everyone in Nostr because everyone is a bunch of public keys. And Milu can help you get to that point, right? So help, you know, build something. Everyone, it's very easy to build. Find something to build. This is the end of my stuff. Thank you very much. I'm on Twitter, André, and this is BitDevs.